Hello everyone, you're welcome to solve this nice exponential equation, which is x to the power 6. This is equal to 4 to the power 6. What are the values of x? Solution from here. The first step is to take 4 to the power 6 on the left hand side, so that we have x to the power 6 subtract 4 to the power 6. This is equal to 0. The next step is that we can express x to the power 6 as x to the power 3 raised to the power 2 subtract 4 to the power 6, which you can express as 4 to the power 3 squared. This is equal to 0. This equation is in the form of a squared minus b squared, which you can express as a plus b, a minus b. From this equation, a is equal to x to the power 3, and we have b is equal to 4 to the power 3. So this essentially means that a plus b, this is the same thing as x to the power 3 plus 4 to the power 3. This is equal to 0. Let's call this equation 1. We have a minus b, this is x to the power 3, subtract 4 to the power 3. This is equal to 0. Let's call this equation 2. Now, from what you have here, let's solve equation 1, which is case 1 here in this case. So case 1 is x to the power 3 plus 4 to the power 3. This is equal to 0. So this is actually the sum of 2 cubes expressed as a to the power 3 plus b to the power 3, which you can express as a plus b. A squared minus a times b, then plus b squared. Now, applying this identity, then we have that x to the power 3 plus 4 to the power 3 becomes x plus 4. Then here we have x squared subtract 4x, then plus 4 squared, which is 16. This is equal to 0. So we have two parts here. The first part is x plus 4. This is equal to 0. The second part here is x squared minus 4x plus 16. This is equal to 0. From the first part here, x1 is equal to minus 4. The second part here is a quadratic equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c. This is equal to 0. From this quadratic equation, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 4, and c is equal to 16. Now, so for x2, x3, we apply the quadratic formula, which is minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c over 2 times a. Now, substituting the values of a, b, and c, here we have minus minus 4 plus or minus the square root of minus 4 squared, subtract 4 times a, which is 1, then times c, which is 16, all this divided by 2 times 1. So this implies here that we have 4 plus or minus the square root of negative 4 squared, this is 16, minus 16 times 4, which is 64, over 2. So this implies here we have 4 plus or minus the square root of 16 minus 64, this is minus 48, divided by 2. So here we have 4 plus or minus. We can express the square root of minus 48 as 16 times 3 times minus 1, all this divided by 2. So this implies here we have 4 plus or minus the square root of 16, this is 4, the square root of minus 1, this is I, then square root of 3, all this divided by 2. The next step here, we can factor out 2. So we have 2 into the parentheses, 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. All this divided by 2. So 2 and 2 here simplifies, so that now here we have 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. So this is what is x2 comma x3. So these are two complex solutions. These are two complex solutions. Now let's proceed to case 2. Let's proceed to case 2 here. Now in case 2, we have x to the power 3 subtract 4 to the power 3. This is equal to 0. Now this is actually the difference of two cubes expressed as a cubed minus b cubed, which you can express as a minus b, a squared plus a times b, then plus b squared. Essentially from here, we have x minus 4. Then here, we have x squared, then plus 4x, then plus 16. This is equal to 0. So this implies that you have two parts here. The first part is x minus 4. This is equal to 0. The second part here is x squared plus 4x plus 16. This is equal to 0. From the first part here, we have that x4 is equal to 4. Now, the second part A is a quadratic equation where A is equal to 1, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 16. So let's apply the quadratic formula to solve for x5, x6. Now we solve for x5 and x6 by applying the quadratic formula, which is minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c divided by 2 times a. Let's substitute the values of a, b, and c. So here we have minus 4 plus or minus the square root of b squared, which is 4 squared, which is 16, minus 4 times a, which is 1, then times c, which is 16, all this divided by 2 times a, which is 1. So here we have minus 4 plus or minus the square root of 16, subtract 16 times 4, which is 64, all this divided by 2. Now, this implies that here we have minus 4 plus or minus the square root of 16 minus 64, which is minus 48, all this divided by 2. So here we have minus 4 plus or minus. We can express the square root of minus 48 as 16 times 3 times minus 1, all this divided by 2. So this implies that here we have minus 4 plus or minus the square root of 16, this is 4. The square root of minus 1, this is I, then square root of 3, all this divided by 2. The next step here is we can factor out 2 here, so that we have 2 into the parentheses, minus 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. Everything here divided by 2. So let's simplify 2 here. So this implies that x5 comma x6, this is equal to minus 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. These are again two complex solutions. And this implies that we have 6 solutions. In this case, we have 6 solutions to this exponential problem. 6 solutions. We have x1 is equal to minus 4. We have x2 comma x3, this is equal to 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. Then we have x4, this is equal to 4. Then we have x5 comma x6, which is equal to minus 2 plus or minus 2i square root of 3. So here we have two complex solutions and two complex solutions. That totals to 4 complex solutions and only 2 real solutions. So kindly follow the steps like this video and subscribe. Kindly like and subscribe. See you in the next video. If you have any other alternative formula, kindly don't hesitate to showcase in the comment section.